Well, the last part in this chapter on wave-particle duality is an important experiment called as the Davison-Germer experiment. It is an experiment which proves the existence of matter waves, that is, that all particles behave like waves. Now, remember the de Broglie's hypothesis, it states that all particles behave like waves. But at the time when de Broglie proposed this hypothesis, there was no experimental proof for it. That's why it was called a hypothesis. But then, later on, Davison and Germer came up with this experiment wherein they showed that electrons behave like waves. So, the electrons, we know they are particles. But in this experiment, they behave like waves. So, therefore, the de Broglie's hypothesis that particles behave like waves was proved. And today, de Broglie's hypothesis is an accepted theory. So, what is this Davison-Germer experiment about? So, we have here an electron gun, which basically generates a beam of electrons. So, how do the electrons get generated? When this filament here, when there's a current passed through the filament becomes hot and it starts emitting electrons through the process of thermionic emission. Now, these electrons, they are accelerated by this voltage V. V is called accelerating voltage. This positive, you see, is applied to the anode plate over here. So, electrons are attracted towards the positive plate anode. And there's a hole in the plate in the center. So, through this hole, a fine beam of accelerated electrons emerge out. So, this fine beam of electrons is then made to fall on a nickel crystal, which is at the center of a circular track on which is mounted an electron detector. Now, this electron detector can count or can basically measure how many electrons are scattered at any particular scattering angle phi. So, this detector can be moved on this circular track so that this phi angle phi can be varied. And at different angles, the number of scattered electrons can be counted or detected by this electron detector. So, what was the observations made by Davison and Germer when they performed this experiment? So, they kept on moving this detector at different angles. They also varied this voltage. So, what they basically did that for different sets of voltage. So, for example, 2 volts, 4 volts, 6 volts. So, for 2 volts, what they did, they scanned the entire range of angle phi, right from 0 degrees to 360 degrees. Then, again, repeated experiment for 4 volts. Again, scanned the detector right round. Then, 6 volts, 8 volts, like that. For different voltages, the detector was scanned and the number of scattered electrons at different angle phi was measured. So, what was an important observation which they made was this, which is shown in the graph over here. So, for a voltage of 54 volts, what was observed is that at an angle, scattering angle of phi of 50 degrees, a peak was obtained. Okay, so the number of scattered electrons suddenly peaked at an angle of 50 degrees when the voltage was 54 volts. So now, this was something which was unexpected. Now remember, electrons are particles. So, this graph is similar to a graph of X-ray diffraction, wherein suppose if you replace this electron beam with a beam of X-rays, then we are expected to get a graph like this because X-rays are waves and they wave diffraction is a wave phenomena. So, only waves can get diffracted. So, X-rays produce this type of a similar graph when we replace this beam of electrons with X-rays. Now, if electrons also are producing a similar type of graph like this with a peak, it implies that electrons, this electron beam is behaving like a beam of X-rays and undergoing diffraction. So, as I told you, diffraction is a purely wave phenomena and only waves can undergo diffraction. So, if electrons are getting diffracted and producing this type of a typical diffraction graph with a peak, it implies that electrons are behaving like X-rays and hence we have a proof that particles, that is electrons, are behaving like waves. So, this is the inferences, observations made by Davison and Germer. So, when the detector was moved on the circular track for different voltages, for a voltage of 54 volts at an angle of 50 degrees, a peak was obtained. So, the peak was similar to a diffraction peak obtained using X-rays. So, that shows that electrons in this experiment, electron beam in this experiment is behaving like a beam of X-rays and undergoing diffraction. So that proves that electrons behave like waves. That is, electrons are behaving like X-rays over here. So this was the final proof of Davison of de Broglie's hypothesis that particles behave like waves. Okay. So today de Broglie's hypothesis is an accepted theory. Now the question arises, before I end this topic, the question arises that de Broglie's hypothesis states that all particles behave like waves, all matter behaves like waves. So even we human beings, or rather any object which we see around us, should also behave like waves. But then why don't we observe our wave nature? Why don't we exhibit a significant wave nature? Now what is important to remember is that only subatomic particles like electrons, protons, neutrons, which are moving very fast, their wave nature is significant. It is not that we are not behaving like waves. Everything, every matter behaves like waves, but our wave nature is not significant and it is almost impossible to detect it. Only wave nature of subatomic particles, very, very fine particles like electrons, protons, neutrons, their wave nature is very significant, and that is what we observe in this Davison-Gemma experiment. That is, electrons exhibit a wave nature. Electrons are behaving like X-rays, which are waves. So that is important thing to keep in mind. So everything, de Broglie's hypothesis is not wrong in saying that all matter behaves like waves. So all matter actually does behave like a wave, but it's only the wave nature of subatomic particles which is very significant, and other macroscopic matter, like the objects which you see around us with a naked eye, they also exhibit wave nature, but their wave nature is very, very insignificant and almost impossible to detect with any instrument which we currently have with us. Okay, so with this we end this chapter on wave particle duality. Thank you.